What's up, y'all? This is Hussein Nasser from iGeometry, where we discuss software engineering by example. And welcome to another Software Engineering Reacts series. So for those who are new to this channel, this series is about I will pick an application, an app, and will basically comment on the user experience and try to use it and try to guess the code and the calls and the requests that are being made and the decisions that the developer made in order to make a better user experience. And I think it's been fun. So we have done an Instagram offline experience while I was on a trip on a plane back to LA from Bahrain, and it was fun for me, and I wanted to do another video. Let me guys know what other apps you want to check out. So today I want to do an Instagram just the feed. I will go through my feed and just talk through the feed and see the comments and the likes and how the calls are being made, like from a software engineering point of view. Does that make sense? Let's go to it. So I made a new account. I didn't want to make up my personal account because I had a lot of private following a lot of private accounts here. So as you go ahead and open Instagram here, the first thing I had, literally, I just followed two people on Instagram, Gary Vaynerchuk and the ESRI account on Instagram here. And the moment I opened that, as you can see, what happened here. So it looks like we got the feed, we got a notification, if you noticed right here, somewhere the heart button, I can't actually touch that, but we got a notification. So the moment I opened Instagram, there was a call to get all the new friends or followers or the comments and the like. I didn't have any pictures, so I didn't get actually likes or comments. But if I did, I would have gotten a notification. So that's the first thing I noticed, right? So that was a call to get all the notifications, right, that I have. So that would be the likes, the comments, and any new followers that have been following you. And I would guess, since I'm a user of Instagram and you guys know that it only shows you the followers and the new notifications since the last login. So since the last time you opened the app, it will not show you, for example, if 50 people followed you the first day and the 50 people followed you the second day, and you open the app in the third day, it won't show you 100. It will show you basically what, since the last time you followed, since the last time you opened the app, how many people followed your, and how many likes and comments. And that, if you think about just taking that, we can talk a lot through it, right? Just think about it, guys. There is a request being made. So there must be some sort of a bit that is stored either on the server or on the client telling me, hey, that was the last time this user used the app. And I am betting that this is on the server stored. And the moment you close the app or just minimize it, maybe, right, it's not active, the server will say, okay, that guy last time he interacted with the app was, for example, an hour ago. And then since that time, that query will be made and the difference will be basically displayed for the user. We can go on just for that, but let's actually work with this application here. So I have the story got loaded here, and Gary V only have the story. Nobody else has any stories here. Let's take a look at this picture, just this picture, right? So I don't know how many pictures got loaded, but I can see them, right? So I don't know. I can't tell Instagram. Actually, You know what? I take this back. If you notice on the right, if I hold that, there's like a little scroll bar telling me how many pictures are there. You can kind of have an indication here. It's like, look at that top right. There's a scroll bar here, right there, telling you that there's like this much has been loaded. I would imagine maybe like the 10 pictures, right? And for this 10 pictures, what got loaded? What do we see here? We see the number of likes. We see the first comment for Gary V. Have fun with your content, right? We see the actual picture. What else do we see? We see the last two comments. And these were picked, right? If you think about it, these were picked very specifically. So I'm guessing that Gary V, obviously, they displayed a comment for Gary himself, and then El Harrington. So I'm guessing if I click this, this is like some famous person, right? He has like maybe 10,000 or more followers, because Instagram will only show you either people who are following you or you're following them. They will show their comments because they want to say, hey, this guy interacted with this picture. Like, you notice that some likes. So it's too bad that I don't have anyone I'm following here. So you'll not see that. You'll notice that, for example, person Mary and Tom and Rick and 23,082 liked this picture, right? So that's another thing. Here we only get a count because Instagram doesn't have a lot to work with my profile in general. So what do we have here? We have the total number of comments and just few comments, right? Because it's just not realistic to list all comments here. So what we got is around 10 pictures, right? The number of likes for each pictures, the number of comments for each picture, and few comments, maybe three. I'm seeing three in here. So that's, if you think of this as a JSON response, like there will be a function called get pictures, and there will be a number, 10, the top 10 pictures, right? And my feed. There, this, the JSON response will be, what? Will be the likes, the picture itself, maybe a URL, maybe the actual binary of the image itself. It could be, I don't think the image is returned, the URL may be returned, because if you work offline, you sometimes see the loading of the picture. So you see the comments, you see the number of likes, but you don't see the picture until later on. So that's actually interesting. So yeah, you get the number of comments, but you don't get all the comments. So it's just like, think about who designed this application. They thought about this really well, right? So they can't just display all the number, all the people who like the app, right? In general, all the like the picture. So what happened if I clicked on the number of likes here? See, that was a quick query, right? It had to load because that's another request to the server. It says, hey, I am clicking this. Give me for this picture who liked this picture. Right, and obviously the same thing here. So do you see how small is the scroll bar? I'm guessing this is like 100. I would say this is 100 or maybe more. Look at that. That's a small scroll bar. So as I scroll, because this is cheap, right? This request is really cheap to return. So I think Instagram just returned maybe 500 or 600, whatever, right? So as you scroll down real quick, Instagram will make another request, I'm assuming. Look at that. That's not 20,000. That can't be right. Look at that. I should have requested the rest. Maybe this is, we just went through 20,000 records. Could it be? I really doubt it. Something is off here. But yeah, so this request just pulled all the, what, 230,000? That can't be 230, man. Yeah. Yeah, it looks like a bug, guys. This, because on Instagram, they didn't show that, hey, this guy is going to query and just view all the 230,000 people, right? So you can see, and it's not refreshing, so it's clearly a bug. That can't be all the people that like the picture. So yeah, so look at that. So I'm guessing this is only maybe 300 people, right? 300 records. And you can return 300 because what do you do? You return the 100, you return the name, and you return the thumbnail of that user, I guess, right? That's not so bad, I'm guessing. But if I am following one of those users, I will also get back whether or not this person I'm following or not. So this will, they detected that I'm not following any of those guys. So that decision or that query must have been done on the server. They intersected this list with my following, and they say, hey, these people, you're not following these people. So that what happened. That's what's happened here, I guess, right? So that explained why when we clicked that loading, see that request, that's a slightly expensive request, especially if you have, I would imagine if you have a lot of followers, because I don't have any followers, right? So what do you have here? If you go back here, no, I don't have, I have like 5 followers. Yeah, 5 followers actually following me. Now, I just created this account literally now. That's weird. Okay. Thank you, guys. But yeah, if I click on comments, same thing, right? We scrolled all the way, and I think this is these comments are sorted by date of posting or date created or date posted, right? And you can interact with every comment. You can like every comment. So what do we have here? So it is showing me, if I'm not mistaken, the last 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 9, 20 or 21. So it's showing me the last 20 comments. Again, it's expensive, right? It's always like if you program or if you write an application, you always think limits. Always think limits. And Instagram, obviously, those guys know that, right? They can't just load you with all this stuff. If you want to see all the comments, you will have to click load more comments, which will load, I would believe, another 20 comments, right? Because not only that, what do we have here? You have the comment, you have the person who commented, and you have another thing here, a piece of information that I believe is these likes, and that is slightly painful for the server. Let me explain. So for each comment, show me how many likes. That's easy, right? So let's get a comment. So this comment got a 1 like, for example, right? Let's move on up, right? And I think it's okay, especially if it's like a show me, hey, this comment has 2 likes, right? So this comment had 2 likes. So it's okay, I guess, right? If you click on this, show me who liked this, and that's again the same query that we talked about. That's interesting, but I guess what is in my opinion, slightly expensive is this. The fact that if I liked a comment, then Instagram has to make some sort of a join at the server side saying, okay, not only show comments, also determine if I have liked any of these comments, right? I just liked this comment now. And now that sent a request to the server in Instagram saying, hey, I want to like this comment. Comment must have an ID, I believe, and it's linked to a picture. And that will create some sort of an overhead. So it's really interesting. So if we came back and we clicked here, and let's take a look. Does the Instagram remembers that I liked some of these pictures? It should have that heart as a solid red. That means because I like this picture. But oh, look at that. Where is that coming? Look at that. So it wasn't that bad. The query is made really quick, but